全部是躺满的病人，住院室那边也是躺的有病人，因为收不进去啊。
其实我也想帮他，但是我们确实没有床位给他们。
就梦里面就全部是这些患者的那些影像在你大脑里面。
去了，我也尽我丈夫和父亲的这个责任。
武汉又活过来了的感觉。
武汉加油！湖北加油！
This is the first pandemic caused by a coronavirus.
People who seem to think they're invincible, well, you're not.
This virus is a virus that's attacking humanity.
I never felt so stressed in my life.
There's no time for playing games.
Against an unknown virus has just been waged in the city of Wuhan, and this man has been fighting on the front line from the very start. Dr. Liu Qingquan is the medical department head at the Hankou Hospital. This office has turned out to be his temporary shelter.
那天晚上吧，应该我说算了，我说我参与这个工作室，那天算了，我是69天，我在这个办公室睡了69天。
办公，在这儿，
对，
这个地方睡了69，
对，
9天。
On the 2nd of January, Liu's hospital was one of the first three hospitals in Wuhan designated for the treatment of the unknown pneumonia.
1月3号，我们收了第一例华南海鲜接触史的一个患者。当天晚上也是下着雨，他们跟我打电话说有这么一个患者发烧过来，家属当时病人想回去。
But even before Dr. Liu set eyes on his first COVID-19 patient, the novel coronavirus was already making its rounds in the city. However, it was mistaken for the common flu due to the many similar early symptoms between influenza and COVID-19.
12月份我们不知道，我们也没有，我们医院没有接触过这样的病人。
每年12月份本身也是发热和肺炎的高发季节，我们知道去年12月份也本身是我们流感那个相对一个高发季节。
That situation changed on December 30th, 2019. An internal document issued by the local health authorities began circulating online.Titled An Urgent Notice on the Treatment of Pneumonia of Unknown Cause, the document asked Wuhan's medical establishments to report suspected cases.
12月30号拿到那个通告的时候，是您第一次知道有这个肺炎？
对，我第一次知道才，我才知道有这么回事。
当天下午就为呼吸科腾了十张床出来，然后规定所有的发热病人要规范收治，没有戴口罩要求当天下午立刻领外科口罩，要求所有一线人员戴上外科口罩。现在回头想起来，这是一个无比正确的一个决定。
一个呢，是因为它确实是一个冠状病毒，它和 SARS 共同属于冠状病毒的这样的一类的病毒，而且再有呢，就是大多数人都会有肺炎的表现，这几点其实都是跟 SARS 非常相像的。
The next day, on the last day of 2019, Wuhan's health commission said there were 27 cases of the unexplained pneumonia, with 7 in critical condition.However, they also claimed they found no evidence of human-to-human transmission or of infections among medical workers. And while some hospitals that had taken in patients with the unknown pneumonia had raised an alert, they were slow in taking action. Meanwhile, the possibility of an epidemic was met with mixed reactions from the public.
可能最近看新闻，就是它人数越来越多了嘛，所以大家还是预防一下比较。
Earlier infections have been linked with the Huanan seafood market. On January 1st, local authorities shut the market, but it didn't appear to have stopped the virus.
什么时候感觉到这种不寻常的？
随着时间慢慢推移吧。因为量慢慢多，到元月中旬以后。感觉病人慢慢增多了。
On January 3rd, China began updating the epidemic information regularly with the WHO and the US. Soon, the true nature of the unknown virus was unveiled. On January 10th, Chinese scientists shared the gene sequencing of the virus with the world. 2 days later, the Chinese government shared more results with the World Health Organization.Laying the foundation for a global vaccine development. And while the virus was believed to have originated at the Huanan seafood market, later studies found evidence of an even earlier origin. There were even suspicions that the virus came from a lab and was created as a bioweapon, yet these theories have since been debunked.
Probably spread in humans for a while. We don't know how long. It could have been months, could have been decades.Of this virus spreading and evolving in some other animal or humans, and then finally, just that one little mutation that occurred that allowed it to spread more rapidly.
But at that time, this knowledge was not available to the people of Wuhan. And since human-to-human transmission was not confirmed, doctors were under-protected. Dr. Zhou Ning from Wuhan's Tongji Hospital was infected during a heart surgery.
哦，这是一个35岁的一个年轻的男性病人，既往病史，他自己有一定程度的隐瞒情况下，我们还没有采集齐全。1月19号我们就给他做了手术，手术很顺利，也大家心情很开心。然后21号呢，他就准备出院，出院的时候他就跟我们的护士说，他曾经发热，现在还有一点干咳，他是华南海鲜市场旁边一个餐馆的厨师。
The same day Dr. Zhou Ning was conducting the surgery, a top-level medical expert team sent by the central government met with local health officials. Dr. Zhong Nanshan led the team. The 83-year-old epidemiologist was regarded as a national hero during the SARS crisis nearly 2 decades ago. After hearing out the local officials, Zhong Nanshan had a string of questions.
I had a lot of questions asking the local CDC people. And after their presentation, I just asked them questions. One, how exactly many patients are there in Wuhan being infected? And the second, whether they had some patient dying. And the third, whether they had medical staff being infected.
到武汉呢，我们来确认在武汉是不是发生过人传人的这样的明显的病例。所以那时候呢，其实从这个省和市的卫健委都能够明确地得到了这个就有人传人、医务人员感染的这样的一些病例。虽然我们不知道确切的数字在当时。 19号做的调研，19号夜间是回到了北京，因为20号要向领导汇报，向国务院领导汇报。
A turning point appeared on January 20th. On that day, Chinese President Xi Jinping, also the General Secretary of the CPC Central Committee, issued his instructions on fighting the coronavirus. Calling on resolute efforts to curb the spread of the virus, Xi Jinping made it clear that the top priority is the safety and health of the people. He said the release of timely information is vital, and it was necessary to deepen international cooperation. On the same day, China's Health Commission announced the coronavirus could spread among humans. During an executive meeting of China's State Council, the threat of the novel coronavirus was also upgraded to the same level as bubonic plague and cholera, which can trigger a mechanism of large-scale quarantine under the nation's current law of infectious diseases.
把它列为法定包括传染病一类，按强烈管理，它就给武汉封城提供了一个法律基础。
On the same night, Professor Zhong Nanshan appeared on state television, warning the public about the virus.
这个资料表示呢，它是肯定的有人传人。I mentioned about the principle is don't go to Wuhan and don't leave Wuhan.
We knew in the last week of January that this was coming. The message from China was absolutely clear that a new virus with pandemic potential was hitting cities.
By now, over 200 infected cases have been reported across China.Several overseas infections also surfaced.
停一下。
With Xi calling for the entire country to be mobilized in order to curb the nationwide spread, in 5 days, 25 of China's provinces and regions had put in place their highest level public health emergency response, covering 1.2 billion people.The city of Wuhan started to roll out more designated hospitals. In addition to the 800 hospital beds, the city promised to add another 1,200 beds and set up 61 fever clinics. A dozen hospitals, including the Hankou Hospital, converted their regular wards to treating patients who had contracted the coronavirus.But even so, they weren't prepared for the number of patients showing up at their doorsteps.
我们十个门诊，我们发热门诊，50个医生，将近100个护士，在那24小时连轴转，都是输液最高的时候达到500个，就是想为更多的病人提供服务。
散开2秒钟，又微信了，就黑压压的，然后这边。然后输液室那边也是躺着有病人，因为收不进去啊，只要是他看到有空地方他就搭张床。
没有办法给他安排进去，然后那天他突然对我们下跪了，所以那件事是最触动我的，就是不是我不帮你，是我没能力帮你。其实我也想帮他，但是我们确实没有床位给他们。
The phenomenal increase in the number of patients quickly depleted Wuhan's medical resources.Masks and protective suits were the last line of defense between medical staff and the virus, and yet they were on the verge of running out. With only 3 days to go before the Lunar New Year, the situation in Wuhan threatened to spiral out of control.
那真是一个至暗时刻，我没想到人变得那么多，很多都是重病人，他们氧饱和度很低，
情况很差，我们想竭力地帮助他，但是我们发现我们可能无能为力。
What complicated things even more, the Spring Festival travel rush, the largest human migration on the planet. It's been estimated that some 15 million people will travel in and out of Wuhan, one of the largest transportation hubs in central China.
我们非常担心春运可能把这病毒带到各处去。
In the afternoon of January 22nd, President Xi Jinping gave the order to enforce the lockdown.For a city with a population three times the size of Los Angeles.
那封城这个决定，我这其实是一个非常艰难的决定。这么大的一个城市，决定给它封城，其实不是轻易的就能够把这两个字儿说出来，是需要有很多全盘的考量。
我觉得这是无奈，因为你想，你要是再过三到五天，甚至七天的准备，也未必准备得好。
There was no time to lose. At 10 a.m. on the 23rd of January, with the Spring Festival only 2 days away, Wuhan was put under lockdown.No one is allowed to come in and out of the city, a totally unprecedented move.
是看到整个武汉市都公交车、地铁全部封城了，然后还有很多人都没办法回家去。其实我是很同情他们的。
Nothing like this had ever happened in modern-day China.
这件事儿实际上它起到了非常大的作用，那就等于把从湖北、从武汉往外走的人群起走了，这就等于把全国这个传染源、这个传染途径给起走了，它给全国甚至全世界它做出了贡献。
The task of enforcing the lockdown naturally fell upon the traffic police. The decision even took the police by surprise.
对我自己来说，首先是内心的这一些障碍，觉得这个信息是不是真实的，然后的话呢，确认了之后，是真实的，那我们就只有执行落实。
In addition to the airport and the city's three railway stations, the police were also required to stand guard at hundreds of roads connecting Wuhan to the outside world.
来看一下这个地图，我们这里看得很明确，这就是整个武汉的这一个外环，就是京港澳高速。武汉市的整个城市交通啊，它是由一环一环的组成，从一环一直到五环，五环就是我们的外环线，武汉外环上面闹武汉的这所有的高速路口全部的上了警力。然后像这一些市内可以出城的这些高速快速路也上了警力，这就是一共是56个这样高速路口全部上了警力，国省道和县乡道，我们第一时间也安排了警力。
Lei Xinbin is one of the traffic police who locked down the city.
说武汉市人民是英雄的人民，一声令下，我就压根没有跟我们非常配合交警的，安排。进城的、出城的，那道路一封闭就没有车辆走了。好，一路平安。
By the evening on the 23rd, Wuhan was no longer what it used to be.
结果开车回到在街面上，完全空荡荡，就像一座死城。那时候感触好大，我没想到这么繁华的城市变成这个样子。确实。这又是增加一副伤愁，看到病人那么重收不进去，心里很伤感。然后在走的街面上看到城市变成这个样子，确实心里上接受不了。
China was facing not just a virus outbreak, but also an unprecedented humanitarian crisis. 2 days into the lockdown, Wuhan found itself facing a dire shortage in medical workers, hospital beds, and protective gear. Many patients, too, were on the brink of collapse.60,000 medical workers in Wuhan stretched to almost breaking point.
开始的时候，我跟他们一样，也是失眠。你只要睡着，你就梦里面就全部是这些患者的那些影像在你大脑里面。
这三个里面是最重的病人啊，抢救的病人啊，都是有气管插管的啊。
只要一张床空出来了，哪怕是那个床上的遗体还没抬走，就已经开始人来预定这个床位了，就到这样的程度。
养兵千日，用兵一时，危难时显身手。
So the central government made another emergency decision, sending in medical workers from other parts of China to assist Wuhan. On January 24th, the eve of the Lunar New Year, the first batch of 450 military medics was dispatched to Wuhan.
我们第一批医疗队是海军医疗队，它应该是24号到的，26号就接管。
Yu's hospital also received help from Wu Jianfeng, an ICU specialist from the southern province of Guangdong. He's one of the first 128 medical personnel sent to Wuhan from Guangdong.
我1月24号当时接到通知，然后晚上就，然后就是两个小时之后接通知，晚上必须出发，啊，然后就是应该，然后就去医院去集合了，然后就开始做。飞机凌晨的飞机到达武汉，我记得还非常清楚，应该是凌晨3点钟左右。
By the end of the first day of the Lunar New Year, more than 1,400 medical workers had arrived in Wuhan from all across China. Their presence was much needed.
他说再迟两天，他们都要崩溃了，真的要崩溃了啊，对吧？就是我们当时一接手，这个病人进来走进来，啪就倒在地上了，啊，就是我们连抢救的这个时间都没有给我们。还有的是有的病人啊，就是我那一天第一天值班的时候，那病人从楼下跑过来，跑上来，然后跪在地上，然后磕头的，啊，因为我们收治的，啊，所以说他们本院的，我觉得武汉的这医护人员，应该说是在早期的时候确实承受巨大的这个压力，有的护士啊、医生呢、啊、在哭啊、大哭啊，我。
休息一下好不好？来，好，你们那很冷，好吗？哎呀，很冷，好吧。
The extra pair of hands eased the initial chaos.
就是我们迅速的去改造这些病房，啊，把它尽量的把它按照一个传染病的一个病房来去整理，啊，还有一个就是什么，尽量去简化，而不是去复杂。刚开始接手的时候，病房护士站里面的那个补液啊，是看不到头的，70多个病人，你想有5-6种补液，一天要补加在一起，护士可能补液要补400-500种。这个不会下去，所以护士都会崩溃了。
Official data suggest that in the first 2 weeks of the lockdown, over 1,000 medical workers in Wuhan have been infected.
所以这样的话，我们可以看到，其实，我相信无论你去 哪个医院，只要在那时候有过经历的，有过很多的病人去拥挤在这么一个非常狭小的发热门诊的这样的一个条件下，其实院内传播几乎没办法避免。
In Hankou Hospital, by the time Dr. Wu Jianfeng arrived, over 40 medics had been infected. But they had no other choice but to carry on.
每一个医护人员心里都会有这样的担忧，对吧？就是担忧在这个治疗过程中间，对吧？有没有可能会被感染？个人的看法就是什么？就是说，把这个更多的是一种责任，我觉得应该是这样。就是病人，就是重症病人，那就是我们该做的事情。如果我这个事情我不做，那我说句不好听话，那我连吃饭的这个资本都没有了，对吧？
你选择了这个职业，你就没有退路，你就必须站在这个战场。
Meanwhile, across Hubei province, over 2,000 medical workers were infected, mostly in January.
这些医务人员就是。说他们是最美的那个逆行者，最美的白衣战士，我觉得这个评价真的是对于他们用任何的溢美之词都不为过。
The situation is critical. On January 25th, the first day of the Lunar New Year, Xi Jinping chaired another Politburo Standing Committee meeting, expressing his gratitude towards medics and people working at the front line. The meeting made containing the spread of the epidemic.The most important task for China. She also stressed that governments of all levels must be mobilized to strengthen their work and undertake comprehensive plans. On the 27th of January, the country announced that all who had contracted or were suspected of contracting the coronavirus would receive free medical treatment. On the same day, entrusted by President Xi, Chinese Premier Li Keqiang touched down in Wuhan.
加油！
He made it clear that all patients would be cared for. He also promised that another 2,500 medical workers would arrive in Wuhan within 2 days. And the central steering group, led by Vice Premier Sun Chunlan, also went to Wuhan.
每天每时每刻把每一件事都公布开来给全世界看，给全国人民看，公开透明。这次我们非常公开透明。有的时候出现一些数字的不准确、数字的误差，我们都进行了及时的校正，要求武汉市的一些方面必须公开，数字一定透明。
救人、救国、救世，
救死扶伤，
救死扶伤，
无私艰辛，
无私艰辛，
为确保人民疫情。
Thousands of medical workers continued to pour into Wuhan to lend a helping hand. The entire country was galvanized.
再一个呢，就是我们要提前的预判，打出一部分提前量来。然后呢，能够保证它快速的这个调动，我觉得这些其实都是非常。另外就是我们国家的一个制度的优势和体制的优势了。就我们国家是公立院主体的，就公立院是主体的话，我们可以随时的来调派这些医院。
Even though it was still during the Spring Festival holiday, manufacturers of medical protective gear across China were asked to resume operations. One of the gear producers is in Beijing, located 1,000 kilometers away from Wuhan.
现在这个疫情是这个很急的，所有的员工正式就是回到工厂开工。
Apart from cancelling all other production plans, the company also freed up more space in order to produce protective garments. Some 200 workers worked 12 to 13 hours daily to churn out the much-needed supplies.
今天初一接到我们张领导的那个复工通知，说随时可能会复工，我们就做好了积极的准备。 初四的时候嘛，我们就每个人都是积极的赶过来，
两周多多的这个努力，现在我们已经能够达到一个一般已经能够达到一个比较满意的一个产能了，就是说每天要可以做到4000件。
Manufacturers across China, including home appliance, car, and phone makers, started to convert their assembly lines to make medical supplies. Meanwhile, in Wuhan, many patients were still waiting for a hospital bed. On the second day of the lockdown, the Huashanshan Hospital, promising 1,000 beds, broke ground.Its design took less than 24 hours, and more than 7,500 workers were involved in the construction. The expectation was that the hospital would be completed in 10 days.
元月24号，除夕当天中午12点到了这个地方。
Song Li is one of the workers.
当天接到的任务就是要布放这个基站的广缆，大概从前方大概900米的地方放到这边来，然后从这边过马路，再进到这个楼顶。
那当时遇到了哪些困难？
前期的时候我们物资也不是很充分，每天大概只能吃一顿饭。
那这个饭是还得自己准备吗？
干粮都还是干粮，
就只有干粮当时。
对、
那我每天一天的工作量是怎么样？
每天都超过了12个小时以上。
Live feeds of the construction site attracted over 44 million views.Senior Colonel Jong Seo-bin from the People's Liberation Army General Hospital is the head of this new hospital.
最着急的就是它什么时候能建成，什么时候交给我们使用，它会不会啊？这个整个的流程，因为我没有见到整个的设计图纸啊，那还是没见到的。能不能满足这种传染病啊，对于抗击新冠这种传染病的要求？首先想到的主要还是这些。
Though it was an emergency hospital, it had to meet all the requirements of a full-fledged communicable disease hospital.
这整个传染病医院，一个是危重病人需要，比如上呼吸机啊、监护仪啊，它不能停。如果靠病人停，靠医生护士去捏皮球，会很危险，会很麻烦，怕影响病人救治。另外呢，作为传染病医院来讲，一旦停电，这个空气就混乱了。医务人员就长期暴露在感染的环境之下。
Massive tasks ahead, and only a week to get the job done.
我每天工作就是能够把事情能够往前面，就能够快的，就尽量让它快。
真是到了最后两三天了，确确实实有这种，包括我们现场的工人也是这样的情绪，就是说已经像使不出来力气了。因为当时已经做了7-8天了，每天都是比较高强度的。
On February 2nd, 10 days after construction began, the Huashanshan Hospital was officially handed over to the People's Liberation Army. In the initial days, these army medics had to do everything from repairing devices to unclogging the drains.
还是不行吧，是吧？
对，慢。
对，那就是管子那个问题，里头可能还是要堵。
对，没事，我待会儿再换个阀子。
抽气八孔。
对，这个阀子不行。
这个不行，这个力不行。
对，我马上换一个。
哎，对，那个力不行。
他那还可以，还能下去。我那天弄的整个大便都是。
哎，这刚才也是的，刚才就是我们那个。
Meanwhile, the second emergency hospital, the 1,600-bed Lei Shen Shan Hospital, which broke ground at the same time, was completed in 12 days. Soon after, Huashanshan Hospital opened its doors to patients. Daily new infections in Wuhan soared to some 2,000. February 2nd, China started implementing the policy of ensuring that all those in need were tested, isolated, hospitalized, or treated. If all of them were to be immediately accommodated, two Huoshanshan hospitals would have to be built every day. To meet the acute shortage of beds, dozens of general hospitals began modifying their regular wards, turning them into quarantine rooms for treating coronavirus patients in serious condition. Meanwhile, there's been a steady increase in the supply of testing kits in China. Since the genetic sequence of the new coronavirus was published on the 10th of January, many companies have tried to develop a test kit. One of them is this biotech company in Shanghai.
那么整个过程呢，大概花了将近十来天的时间。
The company claims that its test kits can detect the new virus by identifying three of its distinctive genes in less than 2 hours and with a high degree of accuracy. But before these test kits can be used by doctors and hospitals, they'd first have to obtain an official license. To facilitate the process, the Chinese authorities immediately set up a fast-track approval channel.
正常的话可能要一年半的样子可能需要。目前按照现在正常上下班的产能，我们可以控制在20万。
While China's testing capability is on the rise, testing facilities in Wuhan are struggling to meet the surging test demands.
这个样本的这个需求的要求检测，
差不多有三百的样子。现实的人员呢，在安排倒班和加班。我们一般晚上做核酸的话，会做到12点多。因为我昨天拍了一些相片，因为很多工作人员都是里外都湿透了的，他出来的时候背心上面绿色的工作服上面全是汗水。我们是从12月底到现在没有一天休息的。
Xiang Jie is in charge of the testing department at Jinyin Town Hospital, which had in early February taken in the largest number of COVID-19 patients in Wuhan. But only 10 minutes after his interview began,
您不舒服了是吧？
身体有点不舒服。
那您先坐一会儿，看你。
对，护士，赶紧来帮忙。
没事。
问一下，你是血糖问题还是什么？我给你抽血。
没事，
就隔壁就有管子，抽不抽起来抽。没有，谢谢。
By the middle of February in Wuhan, the daily COVID-19 testing capacity has expanded 10 times to 8,000 to 10,000 samples. While Wuhan is under lockdown,Across China, 31 provinces and regions have enacted a top-level public health emergency response by the end of January. In the capital, Beijing, railway stations have almost come to a standstill. Staff made it a point to check everybody's body temperature, while disinfection is carried out round the clock. An isolation area has also been set up to deal with possible emergencies.
我来的这一路上呢，都是看到安检人员穿着隔离服、防护镜，这种呢也给我们传递了一种就是现在这个局势的紧张感。
大家好，菜价怎么样？菜价
还行，
还行。非常时期就不握手了，但是咱们呢，但是一定要有信心。
On February the 10th.Xi Jinping visited a residential community, a hospital, and a district center for disease control and prevention in Beijing. He pointed out that communities are the first line of defense, and as long as this line is safeguarded, the spread of the virus can be effectively contained. He also spoke to doctors in Wuhan through a video call.
信心百倍地打好这一场阻击战，总体战。打好这一场人民战争，我们一定要树立信心，一定会胜利的。
To step up the battle against the epidemic, more resources from other regions were channeled into Wuhan and Hubei province. In just 1 month alone, a total of 42,000 medical workers were drafted, over 35,000 into Wuhan, and another 6,000 into other cities in the province. 10% of the country's intensive care specialists were sent to Wuhan. Just on February 9th alone, some 6,000 medical workers arrived in Wuhan to aid the fight.
中央指导组卫健委发出号召之后，基本是全国的31个省区市都做到了这一点。像辽宁宁可把自己的门诊停下来，他也要把他的医务人员送到前线来。连夜，我要特别跟你讲的就是，这些人群里边有70%是女性，伟大的女性到这里来了。
Over 4,000 army medics also came to Wuhan in different batches. Even China's Y-20 transport planes swung into action, loaded with medical workers and supplies, the first time they had taken part in missions outside of military drills.
中国它还是一个集体主义，对吧？就是说，因为你救治的它不是一个个人的一个个体的问题了。这个抗疫过程它实际上不单单是一个医疗问题了，你看它已经影响了整个的经济的，对吧？文化的，对吧？社会的各个方面了。觉得把这个事情如果能够尽快的把它做好，那实际上对于这个各个社会各个方面都是一种英雄主义了。
By the end of February, over $2 billion worth of medical supplies had been donated from across China to Hubei. In addition, over 60 countries and 7 international organizations have also donated masks and protective gear to assist China in its battle against the deadly epidemic.
那么这里边呢，不光是数字，也有很多感人的故事。巴基斯坦拿出全国医院库存的口罩提供给我们，所以这些捐助啊，应该说是雪中送炭，患难见真情，我们将铭记在心。
2 weeks after the lockdown of Wuhan, there was finally some good news. New infections outside Hubei province showed signs of easing. However, in Wuhan, new infections still rolled in the thousands and even tens of thousands. The virus appeared to be unstoppable.
当时我记得最严重的时候，每天确诊病例和疑似病例加在一起要有3000多人，也就是说要求我们每天至少要建设大概是3个医院，所以当时的情况非常危急，非常紧急，工作任务工作量非常大。
With 9 million people still trapped in Wuhan, how can the city keep its healthy population away from the virus?
那个场面你背都忘不了啊！交通车一车子一车的，一来300-400个病人同时住院，
太难了，太难了！再要拖下去，我老爹就没命了。
说这里，我中午饭都吃不下去了。太难受了，不愿回忆这个事情。
And can China find a way to reduce its rising new infections?